Hello everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop here with a review of the newly released Monogram 57 Ford Del Rio Ranch Wagon 2-in-1 kit. You can see on the box you can build it as a beautiful stock wagon or you can build it as a police wagon, both of which are very cool. You might even want to buy two kits. Now, this 57 Ford kit is a continuation of other kits that Revell has put out using the 57 Ford. The first kit that came out was this beauty right here, the 57 Ford Custom. And a lot of people have built that. It's a very nice kit. Then the second kit they came out with on that 57 Ford was the Fireball Roberts. Another beautiful old stock car kit. And now we have the 57 Ford Del Rio Ranch Wagon version of that kit. They just keep improving on it and adding out different versions. Now Model King did release a police car version of this vehicle as well. But it wasn't from Revell or Monogram. It was from them, but with the Model King variation. Like I've showed you on other kits, it was a co-op, you know, designed through them. But this is just all Monogram. I picked this up recently online. The online retailers and hobby shops should have it. It was $19.95 and a heck of a steal. When I opened the box, it was completely full of plastic from top to bottom. Let's take a look at everything that you will get when you buy this great little kit. First up will be the standard Monogram, Revellogram as people call it, manual. And you're going to start off with the engine. Almost always have you start off with the engine. That is the nice 312 cubic inch Thunderbird V8. And what's really cool is we're going to see in here that the manual makes no mention of some parts that are included on the trees with this kit. And it does include the parts for the supercharger, if you are wondering. The supercharger that was included in the Fireball Roberts kit is actually in this kit as well. The manual just makes no mention of it whatsoever. You've got your engine, you've got your frame with all your exhaust, your gas tank. You actually get to build the gas tank on this one, of course. The differential and springs. And then they have you move on to the interior pan, seats, air cleaner, engine. All goes as you would expect if you've ever built a car kit before. Putting on the wheels and tires, radiator, to finishing off the body with all the glazing and putting the hood on. Of course, you're going to build it in the direction you want because you're going to paint it, so you might not be building it exactly in the direction that the manual tells you to. You can see everything goes through very standard. It is a nice big manual. It's 15, 16 pages long. And you'll see on there is one thing that you should know. On this one, maybe I've missed it on other Revell manuals, but right down here, it says when you use the license plate decals to not use water with them, just to cut them out and glue them with white glue. And I don't recall if that's been in any other manuals. Maybe I just missed it, did it myself. But this was the first one where it really stood out to me. On the back is the police car option. Gives you the where to put decals and everything on there. So speaking of the decals, let's take a look at that decal sheet for this kit. The decal sheet is big. There's a lot of stuff on there. You've got regular stock wagon decals, and you've got police patrol decals. And you can see the register and the color is very nice. It's going to be that dark green, which I find very attractive, so I've got no problems with it. Some people might not like it, not want to use them at all. It does have a dash decal. Woohoo! It's got white wall decals, and as you saw on my 69 Charger, when I did that, I used Revell's white wall decals, and they work just fine. I would prefer if they had pad-printed tires, but they don't. And that's just the way it is going to be from Revell. I don't think they're ever going to change that. They do have some kits with pad-printed tires, Revell has. So you can find those, like the 50 Olds, and see if those tires will work. And you can see the center of the hubcaps there. And then we'll just look at some other fine emblems and decals. Now, a lot of people like molded-on emblems. I happen to like decals because I don't use bare metal foil. And then the police patrol decals. You get decals for Clearwater here, Highway Department, or Highway Patrol, Sheriff's Department, Franklin County Sheriff, and another Highway Patrol variant. You can see all those there. Radar Patrol, Radar Dispatched. Very nice decal sheet, very well done. I've never had an issue with Revell decals. Let's start taking a look at all the plastic in the kit. First, what I usually show you is the stuff that I don't want to take out of the bags right away because I want to build this one and I don't want anything scratched up. But you can see the nice windows in there. All the rear glazing is there. And it's very thin. It's flexible, actually. So it's going to be, you know, stiff enough to hold into place with clear glue, but thin enough that you don't get any distortion whatsoever through it. And it's got red parts in there. I love clear red parts. I don't like having to use paint. So I actually prefer that. I'm really happy about that. They've got all that in there for you. The headlights are clear instead of that little fog look, and I do enjoy that. In the chrome bag here, we've got some very nice bumpers, your front bumpers and your rear bumper. And you've got the grill. You can see my finger through that grill. You can see that that grill is molded open, and we showed that to you in another Mobius review of a kit that they had, and I'm so glad they're starting to mold these grills open. And we've got some engine parts. You can leave chrome or strip. We've got the alternator, and we've got some license plate frames, windshield wipers. We've got door handles, reverse mirrors, and we've got those sweet hubcaps. So that's it for the bagged up stuff. Now we got all the stuff that we don't have to leave in a bag. These parts here, molded nicely. Let it focus in. That is your gas tank, your two-part. We've got, looks like, some bumper mounts. If I misname anything, I do apologize. We've got the radiator right there. And it looks like another set of bumper mounts there off the frame. You've got a nice battery. A nice, nice battery. In this tree, we've got the good-looking Steelies, and I really like that look. I really like that look of a wheel. I've always been a fan of that, and that's exactly how I plan on doing mine. Molded well with the wheel backs. You've got separate suspension arms. The big dual exhaust. And you've got some very small lines and parts there. It looks like brake parts on this section. And you've got your pedals up here. Ravel's really showing off how good these new kits can be molded and designed by using such thin castings. There's your springs, your leafs. And we move on to the drive shaft, shocks, gear housing. Let's go over here to another rack of small styrene parts. There's your 312 Thunderbird V8. Heads. Block and transmission are molded as one. Here we've got your oil pan, manifolds, hoses, belt and pulley assembly. Looks like part of the intake and the fan. I'm looking through the camera with you. We've got distributor, starter, coil, a lot of, and the other cars build up, their engines just build up absolutely phenomenally as well. Here you've got an air cleaner and what looks like a fuel line. Air cleaner assemblies right there, fuel line, look how thin that casting is. So nice, so detailed. Now here are some optional parts if you want to run the supercharger. The tree is in there. Very thin on the belt and pulley system. Very nicely done. With the fuel lines like that, you could easily incorporate that and make it kind of a sleeper car. Let's switch over to the vinyls. This is your tire package. You get four of them. There's no name on the sidewalls whatsoever, so it makes it easy to put on your white walls. There's no names on the other side. The tread is nice. So just cut them free and use them. They're nice looking tires. They fit the bill perfectly. In this little bag, of course, I don't really need to show it, but there's your pins for assembly. We're going to go on to some parts here. There's another fuel tank part. Looks like part of where your spare tire will go in the back, or at least the housing for it. And we've got some interior parts there. I'll let you get a good look at them. And this looks like the back seat to me. Nicely done. Here we've got the dashboard. Get a good look at that, and it's a lot of smooth because I do have a decal for that. Slowly go through. There's the hood. Nice and squared off, so it's not warped or anything. It won't fit funny. and a little groove for the hood ornament. So that's sweet. You don't have to worry about not getting that lined up perfect every time. Here's your front bench seat. Great. Ready for those interior decals. And we've got other interior trim panel parts. As you can see in front of your faces, there's the larger part for the back. Very nice looking. Here's a small tree stuffed in with those. You can see suspension components, sway bar, and your differential housing. One of the other trees here are the super nice panels. These interior panels have the detail that's crisp enough that it should be very nice to detail by hand and put those decals on for the interior panels. You can see no issues with that. That little bugger hiding there, look at that. That's your CB radio. 10-4, good buddy. Steering wheel is crisp. Column's got indicators on it and shift lever. Turn it around again. There's your firewall. Great detail. These 57 Fords, like I've mentioned a million times, I'm not the hugest Ford fan, but I am a great kit fan. This is a beautiful car. This is a beautiful wagon. I would drive that thing any day of the week if someone were to bequeath me one. So if one of my subscribers has a 57 Ford wagon or a 57 Ford period, I will wear a Ford shirt 3 times a week if you give me one of these for free. Because simply recognize a cool classic. You don't have to be a certain model fanboy. You don't have to say, I'm never going to build a Ford, I'm never going to build a Chevy, never going to build a Dodge. Just have fun building a good kit. That's your frame, and that's nice and square. You can see. Nice, nice, nice. We've only got a couple things to go here. Here's your pan, and that's flat as well. I don't notice any warping or any issues with this. They're doing a good job of packaging them. I'm sure if you have an issue with a part, Revell has always been really good about replacing stuff as needed. Ooh, that's giving the camera a hard time. That's a lot of white to try to focus in on. You can get a good look at that. And then, last but not least, is that handsome body. And that body is solid. It's strong. It's not thin. It's not too thick. It is flexible, so you can take it on, put it off for test fitting. But boy, is that sharp, isn't it? That's a beauty. Look at that fin design. Tailgate. Of course, you can cut the tailgate free if you wanted. If you're into super detailing, there's plenty of guys that watch my videos that are amazing modelers. Far better than I am. I enjoy modeling. I'm more of a ship guy if you've seen my builds. I don't think I'm too shabby in the ship department. I like building cars as well. But there are some guys out there that are far better than I could ever hope to be. I like the seam in the roof. Looks correct to me, or correct enough. For a $19 model, looks very nice. There is a headliner inside. And there is a spot in there for your light. There are a couple ejector pin marks in the headliner. But if you paint that up correctly, you really aren't going to see those unless someone pulls the body off your model. And you're probably going to push them on the floor anyways if they do that. So that is it. That is the brand new issued 57 Ford Del Rio Ranch Wagon 2-in-1 from Monogram. Again, I appreciate you taking a look. This kit is worth every bit of $19.95. I want you to go pick up one and build yourself a really cool looking wagon this summer. Thanks for watching.